Welcome back to the Scavengers Project video series. In the previous video, we looked at setting up the project and demonstrated the finished product. In this video, we're going to create animations for the player and enemy units from the provided sprite sheet, and also set up the player and enemy prefabs. So let's create a new scene. And we're going to start by creating the player prefab, along with the animations that go with him. So we're going to choose game object, create empty, and we're going to label that player. In our folder sprites, we have a sprite sheet. Now this has already been sliced into multiple sprites. For more information about sprite sheets and sprites, you can see the information linked below. In this case, we're going to grab the first set of frames here, which are the player idle animation. And I did that by clicking the first frame and then shift-clicking the last frame that I wanted. I'm going to take these and drag them onto the player prefab, and then we're going to give this a name. We're going to call this player idle. So this is the animation that's going to play when the player is not doing anything. We're going to put this in our animations folder. You'll notice when we did that, the two components were added to the game object. A sprite renderer, which is going to display the current sprite frame, and an animator, which is going to allow us to play animation. So when we dragged those frames on, these two components were added. It asked us to save our animation, which we saved in our animations subfolder. It also created what's called an animator controller, which is going to allow us to manage what animation is currently playing. We're going to actually move that to our animator controllers folder, and we're going to add some more animations to the player. Let's go back to sprites. And in this case, I'm going to select our two player chop animation frames, drag them onto the player, and we'll call these player chop. We're going to put this in our animations folder. Now notice when we do this, this hasn't added another animator controller. Instead, it's added that animation to the existing animator controller that's already on the player. We're going to repeat the process with the player hit animation. And next, we can check to make sure that that's working. So we can see there's our player idling. Now the animation is a little fast. So what we're going to do is we're going to open the referenced animator controller by double clicking on it. Highlight the player idle state. We're just going to set the speed to 0.5, which is going to be half of our normal speed. Notice that our other two animations have been added as states. And later on in the series, we're going to work out how to control changing between those states via script. Let's check it now. There we go. With the animations done for the player, we're going to go ahead and apply a tag to the player of player. Now, the player tag is predefined in all Unity projects. We've also added a couple of additional tags, food, exit, enemy, and soda. We've done that by going to add tag and typing those into these fields. We're going to set the tag to player, and we're also going to set the layer. Here we've got our default layers, and we've added an additional layer called blocking layer. This is the layer on which all collisions are going to be checked, and so we're going to go ahead and select that for the player. And we added that the same way by choosing add layer and then typing that in. So we'll go ahead and then select blocking layer. We're going to do one additional layer-related thing for the player, which is we're going to set the sorting layer for the sprite renderer. Now, we've predefined some layers here. We've got a floor layer, which is going to be the background, an item layer, which will be rendered in front of the floor, which is going to be the food and the soda, and then a units layer for the player and the enemies. We're going to assign the player to the units layer. Next, we're going to add two components to the player. We're going to add a box collider 2D and a rigid body 2D. The box collider 2D is going to allow us to check collisions against the player, and the rigid body 2D is going to allow us to move the player using the physics system. We're going to set the rigid body 2D to is kinematic. Since we don't really want the player to be flying and bouncing around, we're just going to have him moving in neat grid-based spaces. So we're going to control that using a script and set this to is kinematic. We're also going to adjust the size of our Box Collider 2D to make it a little bit smaller so that the player won't accidentally collide with things in adjacent spaces only when they're trying to move into a space occupied by another collider. There are a few other components that we're going to add to the player as we go, but for now, that's a good starting point. So we're going to take that and we're going to drag it down to our prefabs folder to save a prefab. Now that we've created our prefab, we can temporarily delete the player from the hierarchy, and we're going to create our first enemy. We're going to go ahead and choose Game Object, Create Empty, and we're going to name this Enemy 1. Let's start by adding our animations to Enemy 1. We're going to go back to Sprites, Shift-click the frames of the enemy idle animation, and drag them on. We're going to call this Enemy 1 Idle. This is going to automatically add the components that we need, and then we're going to add the other frames of our animation as well. Add our attack animation. We can double check that that's working. There he is, looking good. And now let's add our box collider and rigid body as well. We're also going to set the rigid body for the enemy to iskinematic, and we're going to apply the enemy tag and assign the enemy to our blocking layer. We're also going to set the sprite render sorting layer to units. With that done, we can drag our enemy down to create a prefab of the first enemy. And instead of deleting this one, we're actually just going to modify it to create the second one. Rename it to Enemy 2. And we're going to drag in our Enemy 2 idle frames. And our Enemy 2 attack frames. Now, when we dragged our animation to our enemy, we created a new animator controller. We're going to move that to our animator controllers folder. Next, we're going to open up our Enemy 1 animator controller, and we'll see inside that all of our animations have been added here as states. Now, what we're actually going to do is we're going to delete the Enemy 2 states from this. We're going to shift-click on each of those and then right-click to delete them. Now, it's going to ask if we want to delete the selected assets. We're going to go ahead and choose delete. And what we're going to do now is because Enemy 1 and Enemy 2 are going to share the same state machine, they have the same two states of idle and attack, what we're going to do is we're going to create what's called an animator override controller, which is going to allow us to use this same state machine and the same script to control it, but just play different animations in each of the states. So we're going to go ahead and choose create animator override controller. We'll call this Enemy 2. And so the first thing that we need to specify is what controller are we going to be overriding. So we're going to choose the Enemy 1 controller and drag it in. And we'll see here are the two original animations that we're going to play, Enemy 1 Idle and Enemy 1 Attack. And so we're going to override those with Enemy 2 Attack and Enemy 2 Idle. In Enemy 2, we're going to change the controller of our animator to now use our animator override controller. Now, if we play the scene, there we go. Finally, let's drag Enemy 2 down to our prefabs folder to create a new prefab. Next, we can delete Enemy 2 from the hierarchy, and we can save our scene. We'll call it Main, and save it in our Empty Scenes folder. Now that we've got our basic prefabs created for our player and enemy unit types, we're going to move on to creating the other tile prefabs we're going to need to lay out the game board. In the next video, we're going to create our floor, wall, food, soda, and exit prefabs.